Megan, 7 questions for the student athletes.
Megan, this was a big night for the team, and how fitting was it for you just to have the type of game you did with all the stuff about Pat up in there?
It was just an extra up today, you know, knowing that, you know, today was, it was Pat's day, and I think that was the mentality for a lot of us, and we just went out there and we just played hard, and we knew that, you know, if we were going to go out there and play, we had to play for her, because this was her special day. So it was just a great day. It was just a great day to play.
Ashara, that was more vintage. Ashara, you looked like you were moving well, 17 points. Are you feeling better out there now?
Yeah, I'm definitely feeling better. I just went out there and just ran the floor, and my teammates got me a ball, and I just got easy points.
Well, the student team do a lot to you, do you think? The points of production, 7th, 8th, 4th,
I think this will help you a lot. I think confidence-wise, it will help me, but I just got to keep being consistent with that and just keep playing my game.
Andrea went out, and she just said yesterday when Andrea ready to leave this team, she has to leave this team. She has to be ready to do it.
Right.
I don't think Ariel meant for you to do it in the second half. We don't want you to have to do it that way, but what was your mindset going into that second half to take care of the point guard spot?
I actually talked to Ariel at halftime, and I just told her we were gonna hold it down for her. Just meaning we were gonna take care of business, we were gonna get it done for her, because she's the leader of this team. You know, she's, you know, what Dean would say, the head of the snake, and we had to have her back. She always has our back in tough games. She's always the one pulling us together. So we got to do that for her tonight, and it was exciting. And that was the mentality I had.
Was there anything she said?
She said, take care of business. She trusted us. She had faith in us, and just hearing that, I mean, we were ready to go.
Thank you. It's not easy. Can you just talk about what Andrea did stepping up in the second half?
I mean, the coaches have been getting on her, like, in practice about being vocal and being active and coming and getting the ball, because, you know, her, Jordan, and, you know, and Ariel are on a string. So whatever Rel does, Jordan and Drea, you know, try to follow behind it. But I think tonight, that really built her confidence tonight to get out there and be able to lead. And, you know, we trusted her being out there on the floor. We were comfortable being out there on the floor with her. And it just excited me to see her take on that role and just be able to, you know, make some adjustments based on what the coaches have been telling her in practice. So it was a good day for her. I'm very proud of her, of how she handled it, and how she was, you know, pushed in that area, because I feel like Ariel trusts her a lot, not just her, but Jordan as well.
Andrea, can you talk about this team's ability with her out to put up these kind of numbers, 27 assists, 89 points, I mean, 10 threes, I mean, these are really big numbers when you're missing your starter.
We just, coming into this game, we knew we had to pull together. We knew we had to lean on each other and, you know, have each other's back the whole time. And then Ariel going out, we just had to do it even more. We just had to come closer. We had to have tight huddles. We had to stay together. And that's what we did, and it was really exciting. It was just such a good feeling getting that kind of win with Ariel out on Pat's big night. So it was just a great night for us.
Megan, you've had a couple of games this year the team has where it went into a slump. It couldn't pull itself out of it. Tonight when Florida made that run in the second half, you guys stepped out of it right away. Hey, what was the difference, do you think?
I think our mentality was a lot different. I mean, the energy was a lot higher. There was an expectation that we wanted to hold from ourselves, not just from the coaches, but within ourselves, that we needed to go out there. We needed to be able to handle adversity. And I think, you know, from the lessons that we learned from the Notre Dame game, you know, from watching film and things like that, I think we made that adjustment, that big adjustment today. And I was proud of how the team, you know, handled adversity. You know, even when Rel went out, that's a big piece of adversity that we had to handle. So we went out there and we handled business and we did what we do best. We just go out there and play Tennessee basketball.
Second, you had two good offensive games in a row. When you set your feet, the ball was usually going in. You're smiling like you already know that. Are you just getting more comfortable? You look like you're more comfortable finally.
I mean, it is a confidence thing, and, you know, I have been, you know, not been able to, you know, be able to hit a lot of the shots that I know I can hit because I haven't been confident mentally in my shot. I mean, I know I can hit those shots. I just have to be confident, like you said, get my feet set and just be ready to shoot. I mean, my teammates always tell me, you know, you can hit those shots, you know, just be ready to shoot at the same time. So I'm still kind of rebuilding my confidence, but just got to be consistent. Like Rashard said, just got to be consistent in the game that I play. Well, we were trying to get our turnovers you know, under 12 today, but I think it was just a matter of us, you know, attacking, penetrating, and dishing, because Florida would help in with two people on the ball, and, you know, Drea would be open, or Jazz would be open, and they hit those really clutch threes, and it was just one of those things that we have to continue to do on any team, especially when we go into Texas A&M, who's number one in SEC right now, so we just have to go out there, and we have to do the little things, and when we move the ball and, you know, force other teams to play defense, it's easier for us to hit those open shots.
Andrea, you guys had 50 turnovers, but yet it was 26-12, your advantage in points off turnovers. How big is it to try and continue that? That's been a real problem.
It's a big deal. This week in practice, we've ran so many sprints because of turnovers, and Coach Law specifically has put a huge focus on turnovers for us. Turnovers in practice, turnovers in the game. We've watched film. When we move the ball, when we have player movement, ball movement, we don't turn the ball over, and that's just what we have to focus on. We're focusing on it in practice. It transferred to the games today. I think we had 11 turnovers until the last 2 minutes of the game, so it's transferring. We just have to keep focusing on it, keep working, and like these two said, just be consistent.
Sure, completely new video for everybody. Sunday now, mm-hmm. Texas A&M and the SEC. You guys have gotten back on the track now in the league. How do you keep that momentum going Sunday?
We just go into Sunday just looking to get a win, just play hard, and just come in with energy. We know everybody's going to be cheering against us, so we just got to stick together and play together.
Take two more. Bashar, could you talk about Jasmine's play today? Threes,
oh my gosh.
Doing a little bit of everything for you guys. Talk about how much of a difference it makes if you can get that kind of
Jazz was amazing today. The coaches know what Jazz can do, and they just keep pushing her in practice to come out and play like she did today. And we need that from Jazz. And I think if she just stays consistent, she can do that for us every game. And we just believe in her, so just keep going at it.
Megan, it's unusual for a senior in a new venue in the SEC. Tennessee's never played at Texas A&M in this league. I know it's your home state. I don't think it's anywhere close to San Antonio, but are you looking forward to Sunday's game?
I am. I've had the, like, playing at AAU, I've had the experience of playing in that arena. So it's gonna be like a little homecoming, but I know there's gonna be some real good home cooking in Texas A&M. So I think we just have to go out there and play Tennessee basketball. I'm really excited, you know, that, you know, my family's gonna be there, but I know there's gonna be a lot more orange than maroon out there when we go there. So I think it's gonna be an exciting game. It's gonna be a test to see how well we handle adversity, and let's see how well we stick together.
All right, ladies, thank you very much.
Thank you.